More than 10,000 jobs lost. Ouch. Not quite half of those will be in positions that are empty now and just won't be filled. The majority of the rest will come from the company's mortgage business. There is some good news for Winston-Salem in that the majority of workers here are in information technology.
Their cost structure on their IT operations here is so good that, you know, if I'm thinking about cutting costs, you know, if I can do the function in Winston and save, you know, 5% cost differential, then, you know, that might be an indication.
It's hard to imagine a company losing that kind of money and still being in business, but at least one economist sees Tuesday's news as good.
This is them taking their losses, they're consolidating, they're refocusing on a productive, competitive strategy, and in the long run, this is going to be a good thing for the banking industry. They're going to be much more cost effective.
While some people are comparing today's economy with the Great Depression, Sherry Gerald says that's just not going to happen.
I don't think we're headed toward banking failures. When those occurred, we didn't have the Fed as a lender of last resort. We didn't have the Federal Reserve that understood liquidity, the importance of liquidity, and the importance of controlling inflation. We didn't have deposit insurance when there were bank runs way back when, so that absolutely will not happen.